using the Laplace transform to solve the initial value problem. So I'm going to do step by step from left to right. So on the left side, I'm going to use the derivative theorem. Apply that theorem. I have s y times capital Y of s minus s y of 0 minus y prime of 0 plus, for this one, 4s capital Y of s minus 4y of 0 plus, so this is phi y capital Y of s equals, on the right side you have delta, so this is called the direct delta function. And if you don't remember, the Laplace transform of direct delta function is equal to e to the negative s t naught, so whatever t naught is, you just plug it in. So I have e to the negative 2pi s, okay? Now look at the conditions. Y of 0 equals 0. This is gone, this is gone. Y prime of 0 equals 0, so this is gone. Alright, so you're left with all capital Y of s's. Factor it out. I have s squared plus 4s plus 5 in parentheses equals e to the negative 2pi s. So this, so you are going to completing the square. That gives me s plus 2 square plus 1, right? When you expand this out, you're going to have s square plus 2 plus 4s plus 4 plus 1, which is 5, okay? Now divide both sides by this one. So I have 1 over s plus 2 square plus 1 times e to the negative 2pi s, right? So you will know why I have to rewrite this in the this form. Right, now take the inverse on both sides. For this one, this gives me u of t minus 2pi. So work this out right away, and you must get it right. Okay, there's no reason for you to get it wrong. Now for this one, if you ignore this, you're gonna have 1 over s squared plus 1, and what is that? But it's psi, right? So psi t. So I will have psi t, right? But because you have the unit step function, the t has to match up with this t, which means that I'm going to have t minus 2pi instead of just t. And that, but it's just psi. Now, don't forget the shift here. So you have the shift, which means that you have e to the negative 2t. And again, the t has to match up with this t. With that being said, it's going to be negative 2 times t minus 2 pi. Okay? So your final solution will be e to the negative 2 times t minus 2 pi times psi of t minus 2 pi times u of t minus 2 pi. Okay, so all of the t's have to match up. And you want to make sure if you get this right or wrong, well, you just find the last transform of this one, and it should definitely give you this one, okay? So that's your answer. That's it. Oh, by the way, for this one, if you want to go further, well, you can. Yeah. So the alternative way of writing this one is in terms of psi t, okay? So psi of t minus 2 is same as psi t, right? Because the periodic is periodic, its period is 2 pi, even pi, I mean. So when you add or subtract even pi, it will give you exactly the same as psi t. That's a property of psi and cosine. This case is psi specifically. So that is a different way of writing your solution. That's it. If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.